गुड मॉर्निंग स्टूडेंट्स, टुडे वी आर गोइंग टू लर्न हिस्ट्री चैप्टर 3 जैनिज्म एंड बुद्धिज्म। एज वी नो अबाउट दैट द रिएक्शंस ऑफ द हिंदुइज्म, जैनिज्म एंड बुद्धिज्म इमर्ज्ड रोज इन द इंडियन कॉन्टिनेंट इन द 6th सेंचुरी BC। The Aryan settlements expanded to the east, accompanied by rapid socio-economic and political changes. Society at some places had traits of tribal political organization, while at some other places, kingdoms were on the rise. Materialism and spiritualism both existed side by side. Materialism means the physical comfort of the things, the materials, the people, were the commodities people were used. Spiritualism means that about in Hindi it is known adhyatmikta, means completely surrendering towards the God and religion. That is known as a spiritualism. The people in the later Vedic age began to use implements and tools made of iron. The iron tools enabled them to clear forests, bringing more land under cultivation and lead a settled life. Means we had studied and knew about the civilizations. The iron ore, the iron had been discovered, and then iron has been used as a metal, iron metal used as for the weapons and tools. As we know, we had studied about the copper had discovered at first, and then later on iron. Then iron has been used, tools used for the cutting the trees, chopping the trees for the more land to acquire for the agriculture. As a result, there was surplus productions of food grains. This surplus produce could be utilized by the kings to meet their military and administrative needs. It could also be used by the people in the towns who specialized in various arts and crafts. All these advantages enabled the people to lead a settled life and to expand further in neighboring areas. As we know, we had studied about the early life. Now, the beginning, the civilizations we had studied, the civilization like Mesopotamian civilization, Harappan civilization, Egyptian civilization, Greek civilizations, Wanghu civilization, Chinese civilizations, these all given a rise to live a settled life and civic life. Means people, they settled down in bank of the rivers. This expansion resulted in wars between different tribes. In these wars, the larger and more powerful tribes defeated the smaller ones and expanded their territories and created large kingdoms. Means in the beginning, the small tribes were groups, people were ruled by the kings or the leaders, or the we can say the sardars. Or they had fought together and then they had defeated to their enemies or the neighboring kingdoms, and they had expanded their kingdoms, and that is known as Janapadas. A number of Janapadas joined together to form bigger and more powerful independent kingdoms called Mahajanapadas. Janapadas means a kingdom, a territory ruled by a king. And Mahajanapadas means several kingdoms joined together and become a great territories or the kingdom, that is known Mahajanapadas. This 6th century BC is regarded as an important epoch in world's history, which saw the emergence of thinkers like Zoroaster in Persia, Confucius in China, Mahavira and Gautam Buddha, along many others in India. In India, it was the period when orthodox religious beliefs and practices were challenged and even rejected by the new sects. Of these sects, Jainism and Buddhism emerged as the most potent religious reform movement. Means here we heard about the some new thinkers like Zoroaster in Persia, Confucius in China, and Mahavira and Gautam Buddha. They brought new thinking, new awakening, and then orthodox religious beliefs and practices were, orthodox means traditional rules and beliefs were in the religion, they have left it behind, and new kind of innovative thought and new kind of thinking emerged in India, even in Persia and in China. It brought a great religious reform movements. Now here, how can we know about these kind of the new changes had come? So here we have to have some literary sources. Through that we can know that there were in India took some changes or the reform movement took place. The three important sources which provide information about Jainism and Buddhism are the follows. First, Angas. Angas was the book of tell about the omniscience of Mahavira. Angas is generally accepted that whatever Lord Mahavira taught after gaining omniscience was compiled by his disciples in 12 parts called Angas. Sanskrit word for parts, these Angas are collectively known as Dwada Sanghi. The foremost of these Angas is Acharang Sutra. Another well known Anga is the Vyakhya Pranapti, which is more popular known as Bhagavati Sutra. While the former deals with the code of conduct which a Jain monk is required to follow, the latter expounds the Jain doctrines in the comprehensive manner based on these Angas. The seers also compiled 12 auxiliary works that came to be known as Upangas. It is said that these Angas and Upangas were not written for a long time. They were orally passed on by the religious leaders to their pupils. Means Upangas and Angas, these were the one kind of Mahavira's teachings had been compiled, and it had rules and regulations written for the Jain monks, and the Jain monks were following, but it had not written, it was orally passed by one person to the another. According to the famous historian R.C. Majumdar, towards the close of the 4th century BC, a famine in South Bihar led to the exodus of an important section of Jinas headed by Bhadra Bahu to the South India. Means, according to the R.C. Majumdar, he expressed about that in बिहार इट हैड टू ए फेमाइन, फेमाइन मीन एक्सट्रीम स्कार्सिटी ऑफ फूड ड्यू टू द ड्रॉट, मीन्स ड्रॉट मीन सुखाड़ और अकाल, यू कैन से. सो ड्यू टू दैट द पर्सन दैट जिनास हेडेड बाय बहु भद्रा, भद्रा बाहु ही हैड मूव टू साउथ इंडिया. दोज दैट रिमेन बिहाइंड इन पाटलिपुत्रा कोर फॉर अ काउंसिल इन ऑर्डर टू रिवाइव द नॉलेज ऑफ द अंगास. द रिजल्ट वॉज द कंप्लीशन ऑफ द 12 अंगास एट अनदर काउंसिल हेल्ड एट बालाभी इन गुजरात इन द 5th और 6th सेंचुरी AD. ए फाइनल कलेक्शन ऑफ द स्क्रिप्चर वॉज मेड फॉर द फर्स्ट टाइम इन अर्ध मगधी प्राकृत लैंग्वेज. मीन्स हियर वी कैन सी अबाउट द काउंसिल इन पाटलिपुत्र सैट डाउन फॉर कंपाइलिंग टू द अंगास द स्क्रिप्चर्स ऑफ जैन रिलीजन, मीन्स पवित्र ग्रंथ. And another Balavi in Gujarat also, then 6th and 5th AD had been together, they came and they completed the Jain scripture in Ardha Magdi Prakrit language. The Angas are regarded as the most important part of the Jain doctrines. They discuss religious rites, stage of the householder's life, the vows of the charity or chastity, rules of conduct and other features of Jain philosophy. The next we have to see that is Tripitikas. Tripitikas are the most important literary works of the Buddhist. Means Tripitikas is a holy scripture of Buddha, Buddhist. The word Tripitika means three baskets of Buddhist canon. Canon means law, principles, or law means Buddhist law or Buddhist rule or principle which had been compiled in Tripitikas. The earliest writings of these texts were taken on long narrow leaves seven together on one side and bound the bunches, then stored in baskets. Means earlier the law and rules and regulations and the principles written into the leaves of a tree, and they compiled it, bound it and made a collection. Therefore, they were called the three baskets. These works written in Pali language include the following. As we know that Jain scriptures written into the Ardha Magdi Prakrit language and the Buddhist language holy book written in Pali language. The first we see the Vinaya Pitika deals with the rules and regulations which Buddha promulgated for the monks, means bhikshus, and the nuns, bhikshunis. It also gives an account of the life and teaching of Buddha as well as some important aspects of the ancient Indian history, customs and arts of the period. So here monks means those who are the sannyasis or the bhikshus of the Buddhism, they known as a monk. Even that some nuns were, they were known as bhikshunis. The Sutta Pitika comprises the discourse of Buddha on various occasions. It also has discourse by some of the principles of Buddha such as Sariputta, Ananda and others. The Dhammapada means the way of truth is an important component of the Pitika which comprises Buddha's teaching. Third, Abhidhamma Pitika deals with Buddhist philosophy. It describes things like the working of human mind and the state of matter. Besides being the most reliable source of information about Buddhist religion and philosophy, the Pitikas provide a glimpse of the social, economic and political life in age of Buddha. Glimpse means the momentary information or the partial views, not only about the social but also economic and political life of the Buddha. Third source is Jatakas. Jatakas refers to the tale which describes the previous birth of Buddha in both human and animal form. Means the previous birth of Buddha in both human and animal form. Each tale begins by the nothing of the occasion that prompted its telling and ends with the Buddha identifying the lives of the people in the introductory story which such people from the past. The future Buddha may appear in them as a king, an outcast, a god, or an elephant. But in whatever form they exhibit some virtues, the tale hereby highlights. Means here about telling about the Jatakas stories about the Buddha's appearance in the future like a king, as an outcast or a god or an elephant. Many Jatakas tales have parallels in the Mahabharata and elsewhere in non-Buddhist literature. The Jataka stories have also been illustrated frequently in scripture and painting throughout the Buddhist world. According to A.K. Wader, the Jatakas are a precursor to the various legendary in scripture and painting, legendary biographies of the Buddha, which were composed at later dates, although many Jatakas were written from an early period, which describes previous lives of the Buddha. Very little biographical material about Gautama's own life has been recorded. However, the Jatakas throw significant light on the political, economic and social conditions of people from the 5th to the 2nd century BC. They also reflect Buddhist morals, ethics and principles. Ethics means moral principles that govern a person's behavior or rules. So students, kindly go through your lesson. Next class we'll see causes for the rise of Jainism and Buddhism. Thank you.